Hello and welcome to another episode of Inside Admission at Wilmington College. I'm your host, Danny Harp, and I serve as the Associate Director of Admission here at the college. Joining me today is one of my colleagues from the Office of Admission, and I'm going to allow him to introduce himself.
Hello, my name is Steve Cukovecki, and I serve as a Senior Admission Counselor here at Wilmington College.
So, January 2021, we are still in the midst of a pandemic, and it has made us rethink everything, even right down to the prospective student who may be wanting to visit a college that they might be considering for fall 21. And while we have taken many steps in regards to setting up guidelines to keep our visitors safe and certainly our campus community safe, we realize, and I certainly realize as a father and certainly as a husband, that there are still those who are a little hesitant or who are just simply waiting until this all passes before they visit a college campus. But what Steve and I want to do today is to assure you that indeed our campus is open for college visits, and we are doing everything we can to keep you safe during your visit. And we cover those protocols on another episode that you're welcome to go back and find and review. But today what we want to do is emphasize the importance of visiting a college campus. And Steve, I'm going to ask you if you could share with our audience, what do you feel are the benefits for a student and their family to get to a campus and to have that all-important campus visit?
Danny, I'm glad you asked that question because we get this question a lot from students. The benefits, there's a lot of them. It's the benefit of a student getting on campus, being able to see our campus, being able to see our buildings, being able to see our facilities that we have here. And also one of the biggest benefits is talking with us, an admission counselor, kind of going over what do they need still, you know, what is the process. But when they give that tour, that's the piece that I think sets us aside from everyone else. It's meeting with that student that they get to talk with and they get to ask questions. What's student life like on campus? How do you balance, you know, work if you're working and studies, things like that. So those are the benefits that they're going to get coming on campus. Mm-hmm. It's not something we can talk about over the phone. We can. But once they get here and step foot on campus and get to see the facilities and see our buildings and meet with us, that's when I think it's a huge benefit for them and okay. Their families.
Very good. And you mentioned talking on the phone. There are a lot of things that we can talk about on the phone, obviously, but I think visiting a campus, you get to meet the people, whether it be a Steve, a Jenny, a Heather, a Danny, mm-hmm. a Jesse, and you get to see the campus like you just mentioned.
Yes.
In those conversations that you have with students when they do visit, what types of things do you cover for them as well as their family?
First thing I always do is, like, when a family gets here, I like to tell them about Wilmington College itself. Talk a little bit about the history of what Wilmington College is, what we can do for them, the hands-on learning, hands-on living that we provide here. Depending on their area of study, what they're going into, I talk about the major that they're going into, maybe opportunities as far as an internship or a job or classes they're taking. Also, the important things is that all of us counselors, as we do, you know, we always know our student coming in, so we kind of know if they're at app received, if they're applied, if they've been accepted, or maybe they're just at inquiry status where we still need some things, some documents. So that's something I like to go over in my meeting is making sure that they have everything in to get them at that accepted point. And then once they are at that accepted point, then we talk about the process of what goes on after that, deposits and registrations and things that come on later on.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and I'm sure, you talk about the financial aid piece as
yes,
well.
Yes, definitely talk about the financial aid.
Having the opportunity to talk that through. And again, all of these types of conversations can take place on the phone, but I think from an admission counselor point of view, at least my feelings, and I think your feelings mm-hmm. as well, it's such a better experience.
It is.
To really be in person and be able to have those conversations one-on-one.
Yes.
Would you agree?
I would agree.
Okay. And then also, Steve, I want to point out to our audience, not only are they able to meet with a counselor, get a tour from a student ambassador, but what other types of things are available for students to experience when they're here on campus, as far as maybe people they might meet with?
They could actually, before coming to campus, if they want to meet with the professor, and if the professor feels safe enough to do that, they can do it in a social distance manner. So we've had those opportunities. They can meet with coaches. They can meet with, you know, other people that's working here at the college. I've had several students that have had food allergies, and they're like, well, I come on my visit. Is there anybody I can meet with there at Sodexo? And I'm like, yes, we could definitely do that.
Okay.
So we've had some meetings like that. Those are far in between, but it's something we do here at Wilmington College. You know, we go over and beyond to make sure that we can get everything set up in that visit when they get here on campus.
Very good. And the way our visits are set up, if you were to go online and register through our website, or if you were to call the Office of Admission and actually talk to Christonia, who is our visit coordinator, tell her exactly what you'd like to experience while you're here. If, like Steve said, you'd like to meet with a coach, a professor, someone else on campus that might be over a particular area that you're interested in, we'll be happy to set that up for you. I should say Christonia will be happy to do that for you on your visit. Steve, I'm curious. I mean, you're a dad.
Yes.
You've got a family.
Yep.
Are you comfortable, or would you be comfortable, knowing what our protocols and our guidelines are as far as keeping everybody safe, would you be comfortable in bringing your prospective student to Wilmington College for a campus visit?
Danny, I would have to say 110% yes. As everyone knows, may or may not know, you and I both have seniors this year. Mm-hmm. You know, my son and your daughter. Mm-hmm. I also have three family members that are here besides my son. And that was the big thing. You know, I wanted to make sure that they're going to be in a safe environment.
Mm-hmm.
Are we going to be social distance? Are we going to have room for them to be able to still interact with their classroom and their student body, mm-hmm. but still get that college feel? And the answer is yes. We checked all those boxes. Mm-hmm. You and I have met before, and we've talked about that. We mm-hmm. said, you know, as a parent, we want to make sure that Wilmington's doing everything they can.
Yeah.
And we've done that. Wilmington has done that.
Yeah.
And that's something that families, I have gotten emails and I've gotten phone calls from students that came in this year
mm-hmm.
that was kind of skeptical because they know other colleges wasn't going into it,
mm-hmm.
but we did, and they're very happy with it.
Yeah.
Our students have done a great job of patrolling each other.
They have.
Making sure that they're, you know, social distancing, that they're wearing masks,
yep.
that they're doing everything to be safe,
yep.
you know, to be here in person.
And that's one of the things I think that has really encouraged me is our administrators, our staff, our faculty, we all have adhered to the guidelines.
Yes.
But then I look at a campus of students and they are adhering to the guidelines as well, knowing the importance of keeping them in class and keeping any visitor or guest that might be here, keeping them safe.
Yes.
I've been really proud of our students as to how they've been able to manage that. Again, the protocols that are in place as far as a safe campus visit were covered on a previous episode. We would encourage you to go back and watch that particular episode, and we will be happy to explain all the ins and outs of what we're doing to keep you safe and to keep our campus safe. Steve, thank you for joining me today and helping.
Always a pleasure.
Well, thank you, Steve. I appreciate it.
You're
and
welcome.
Want to encourage folks to come out and visit us, knowing that they can do so in a secure and safe manner. And thank you for joining us. We'll look forward to seeing you next week for another episode of Inside Admission.